This is the third video of our series, Cell and Molecular Biology. In this video, we will cover what you should know about viruses. In the 19th century, scientists like Louis Pasteur believed that bacteria caused infectious diseases in plants and animals. However, some diseases like tobacco mosaic disease in tobacco plants and hoof and mouth disease in cattle didn't seem to involve bacteria. Researchers discovered that SAP, a fluid transported in vessel elements of plants, when it transferred from sick tobacco plants, could spread mosaic disease to healthy plants, even when no bacteria were visible under a microscope. To investigate this further, Dmitry Ivanovsky, a Russian biologist, passed the SAP through very fine filters that could block even the smallest bacteria. Surprisingly, the filtered SAP still caused disease, leading Ivanovsky to propose in 1892 that there were tiny pathogens smaller and simpler than bacteria, which they called viruses. In 1935, Wendell Stanley found that the virus causing tobacco mosaic disease could form crystals and mistakenly thought it was a protein. In reality, this virus was a tiny rod-shaped particle consisting of a single RNA molecule surrounded by a protein shell. According to today's understanding, viruses share many common characteristics. Number 1, viruses are intracellular parasites. Viruses are obligate intracellular parasites, meaning they cannot replicate or reproduce independently. They rely on the machinery and resources of a host cell to carry out their life cycle, including replication and assembly into virus particles. Number 2. Viruses have multiple forms of genetic material. The genetic material of viruses carries either DNA or RNA but not both. In terms of the structure of their genetic material, it can be single-stranded or double-stranded. So we have different forms as follows. Double-stranded DNA or dsDNA, like the herpes viruses and adenoviruses, has a double-stranded DNA genome. This means they carry their genetic information through two complementary DNA strands. Double-stranded RNA or dsRNA, such as reoviruses, carry their genetic material as double-stranded RNA. These viruses have RNA molecules that form a double helix similar to DNA. Single-stranded DNA or ssDNA, like parvoviruses, has a single-stranded DNA genome. Their genetic information is stored in a single DNA strand. Single-stranded RNA or ssRNA. Many viruses, including the flu virus influenza HIV and the common cold virus rhinovirus, have a single-stranded RNA genome. This means their genetic information is carried in a single RNA strand. Generally, RNA viruses are more mutable due to many factors like the requirement of error-prone replication enzymes and lack of proofreading mechanisms. This genetic material contains the instructions for building new virus particles. The genetic material varies in length depending on the virus. In terms of the amount of genetic material, viruses can have only a few genes, tens to hundreds. Number 3. Viruses have a protein coat. The protein coat, known as a capsid, surrounds and protects the viral genetic material. It also plays a critical role in recognition and attachment to the host cell. Also, it helps in packaging and condensing the viral genetic material into a compact and stable form. In some cases, viruses may modify their capsid proteins to evade the host's immune system. Additionally, some viruses have an envelope. The viral envelope is a lipid membrane surrounding certain viruses' capsid protein coat. It's derived from the host cell's membrane. When the virus exits the host cell, the envelope helps the virus infect host cells by facilitating attachment and entry. It also makes the virus more susceptible to environmental factors like drying or heat, affecting its stability. Viruses with envelopes include HIV, influenza, and herpes viruses. Number 4. Viruses possess various shapes. Some viruses have capsids shaped like a 20-sided figure called an icosahedron. For instance, adenovirus causes respiratory infections and has this shape in some animal viruses like HIV. There is an outer envelope made of lipids, which come from the host cell's membrane as the virus leaves the cell. Bacterial viruses called bacteriophages are quite complex. They look like moon landing modules. They have a head with DNA inside, as they inject DNA into bacteria and tail fibers that help them attach to bacteria. Number 5. Viruses lack metabolism. Viruses do not have the metabolic machinery required for energy production or other metabolic processes. They cannot carry out functions like respiration, growth, or reproduction on their own. Number 6. Viruses lack cellular structure. Unlike cells, viruses lack cellular structures such as organelles like mitochondria or nuclei in a cell membrane. They are much simpler in structure, consisting mainly of genetic material and a protein coat. Number 7. Viruses are host-specific. Each virus has a specific host range, meaning it can only infect certain types of cells or organisms. This specificity is determined by the interaction between viral surface proteins and specific receptors on the host cell surface. Number 8. Viruses replicate within the host. There are two main types of viral infections. In the first type, the virus takes over the host cell's machinery and uses its materials to create new viral genetic material and proteins. These components come together to form new virus particles. Eventually, the infected cell bursts open lysis, releasing a new generation of viruses that can infect nearby cells. This is called a lytic infection. In the second type, the virus doesn't kill the host cell, but instead inserts its DNA into the host cell's own DNA. This integrated viral DNA is called a provirus. What happens next depends on the virus and the host cell. Some bacterial cells with a provirus behave normally until they are exposed to a trigger like ultraviolet radiation. This activation causes the dormant viral DNA to become active, leading to cell lysis and the release of new viruses. Some animal cells with a provirus produce new viruses that bud off from the cell surface without killing the host cell. HIV, the virus that causes AIDS, works this way, allowing the infected cell to survive for a while and produce more viruses. In some cases, animal cells with a provirus lose control over their growth and division, becoming cancerous. Scientists can study this process in the lab by infecting cultured cells with specific tumor-causing viruses. Number 9. Viruses are highly variable and mutable. Viruses can mutate rapidly due to errors in their replication process. This high mutation rate leads to genetic diversity among viral populations. It is one reason why viruses can evolve quickly, potentially making vaccines and antiviral drugs less effective over time. Number 10. Viruses are infectious particles. When outside of a host cell, viruses exist as infectious particles called virions. These virions are capable of infecting other susceptible host cells. They can be transmitted through various means such as air, bodily fluids, or direct contact. Number 11. Viruses are not considered living creatures. Viruses are not considered living organisms because they lack the essential characteristics of life, such as the ability to carry out metabolic processes and reproduce independently. They are often described as biological entities that straddle the line between living and non-living matter, as they can only replicate within a host cell. That was everything for this video. Thank you for watching.